Alright guys, we're back staring at my engine bay, and in this video we're going to talk about fuel pressure crashing. So you're probably watching this video because you did a pull, and in the middle of it, your car did like a big backfire, or you might have heard like some quick misfires, you know, kind of like quick gunshots. And if you experience that, the most likely cause is because your fuel pressure is crashing. And if you just tuned your car, what I recommend is running a log if you haven't already, or checking the logs that you've ran in the past, and this will allow you to verify that your fuel pressure is holding steady. So make sure that you have your rail pressure or high pressure fuel pressure target and actuals in your logs, and scroll across the pool and you'll see as your target stays flat, your actual will begin to dip. Now the Gen 1 B58 is designed to run around 200 bar or 2900 psi, and the Gen 2 B58 is designed to run about 350 bar or 5000 psi. So if your fuel pressure dips too far from that target pressure, then you'll experience those misfires or that big backfire. So with a direct injection engine, you need your high pressure fuel pump to increase your fuel pressure before injecting fuel directly into the combustion chamber. And if the pressure isn't high enough, then your spray pattern gets weak, which causes the misfires, and that's really what you're experiencing. Now, there's a lot of misinformation about what actually causes this, so I want to try to say this and explain it as clearly as possible. This is what your fuel pump looks like on the B58. You can see it's all metal. It's a completely mechanical system. You have this one sensor on the end, but it doesn't actually control anything. This spring is extremely heavy duty. You can't really squeeze it if you want to, but this is a very reliable and very durable component. It is not likely that your fuel pump is failing. It's extremely rare for a high pressure fuel pump to fail because it's completely mechanical and extremely robust, extremely heavy, and it's a high quality piece. But what's happening is this piece is riding on your cam. The exact same way that your cam turns and pushes your valve train up and down, it's also pushing on your cam follower that pushes the spring up and down. And as the spring pumps in and out, it's creating your fuel flow. The faster the cam turns, the faster the spring will pump up and down, which means the more amount of flow your high pressure fuel pump can push out. Now, this is an illustration that I've used a couple times to try to explain how a high pressure fuel pump works, but as you get closer to redline, the fuel pump can flow more fuel. As long as the airflow is only demanding a certain amount of fuel that's within this region, you will not have an issue. But if your boost pressure is too high, where the amount of air that it's creating requires fuel in this region, then you will have a fuel pump crash. Your fuel pump is crashing because the amount of airflow coming into the engine due to the amount of boost pressure your car is creating requires more fuel than what your fuel pump can provide. So long story short, you're running too much boost, and that's where the issue is. It doesn't matter what fuel you're running. It doesn't matter if you're on an ethanol mix. Your tune is requiring too much boost for how much flow your fuel pump can provide at a set level. So commonly people start experiencing this when they switch to an E30 tune, and that's because the amount of boost that the tune requires is enough to overwhelm the fuel pump if you're running more than like an E32 mix. So make sure you're calculating your mix correctly. I have a video on my channel to help you figure out how much ethanol to add, but if you're not measuring your ethanol content and calculating it at the pump, and you're just going off of, you know, somebody told you that you mix 4 gallons of E85 with 9 gallons of 93 or whatever that might be, that is most likely your cause. You're not getting an accurate mix, and too much ethanol is causing your fuel pump to crash on that tune. But the same thing can happen even on 93 octane. Even though the amount of airflow that the fuel pump can support on 93 octane isn't as limited as it would be on an ethanol mix, you can still run too much boost for how much flow the high pressure fuel pump can support. And this is even more common with the stock turbo, because the stock turbo spools extremely quickly and has a lot of boost capacity down low, where your high pressure fuel pump is the weakest. So if your tune doesn't properly taper in boost to compensate for your high pressure fuel pump limits, you can overwhelm your fuel pump. And I'm actually seeing that more and more people on 93 octane tunes are running into fuel pump issues. So again, it's extremely unlikely that your fuel pump is failing. Upgrading to a bigger fuel pump just to run a stage 1 or stage 2 tune is putting a band-aid on the issue. The issue is you're running too much boost for the amount of fuel that your fuel pump can provide. So if you have a 93 octane off the shelf map, or you're running an E30 tune and you know your E30 mix is right, and you're still experiencing dips in fuel pressure, then send your logs to your tuner so that they can get that data And if they need to make an update, they can do that. So hopefully this video helps. If you have any other questions or comments, leave them down below. Thanks.